Okay, I know about the pre-order traversal, in-order traversal, and post-order traversal. Do I really need to know one more traversal technique? What the hell is level order traversal? Well, if you think about it, when we start learning about the binary trees, or just trees in general, we discussed all of these levels, right? That this node is at a level 1, this node is at a level 2, this node is at a level 3. So, how do you take advantage of it? Could there be another traversal technique that can come in really handy? Yes, that is level order traversal. Hello friends, welcome back to my channel, a place where we explore the life of technology and make programming fun and easy to learn. In this video, we will be discussing the level order traversal. So what we're going to basically do is, we will take up a sample binary tree and then we will perform level order traversal on it. You will actually see what is the main idea behind it and what data structure do we need. Then what we're going to do is, we will also do a dry run of the code so that you can see how it actually works behind the scenes. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so you have this tree in front of you and you want to perform a level order traversal. But the first question that should come to your mind is, what are actually levels in a binary tree? If you remember from my introductory videos, I talk about all of these definitions. For example, the depth of a binary tree is defined as the distance between the root node to the deepest node in the tree. So this would be the depth or the height of the tree. And similarly, you have depth of each node. For example, the depth of root node is always equal to 0, right? The depth of these two nodes would be equal to 1. The depth of these three nodes equals to 2. So the depth of a node is the distance of the node from the root node, right? So in a way, these are also the levels of a tree. So you can say that this is one level, this is second level, this is third level, and this is the fourth level. So when I write it out, I can say that this is level 1, this is level 2, this is level 3, and this is level 4. So if someone asks you, do a level order traversal, that just means that you have to go through all of the levels in a serial order. So you will start with level number 1. So you see node number 2 over here, right? So you can write down 2. Next, you see level number 2, right? So level number 2 has the nodes 8 and 4. And look at the order in which they are appearing. First of all, you get node number 8, and then you get node number 4, right? You have to go from left to right. So you can continue writing your traversal. So the next value would be 8 and 4. Moving ahead to my third level, I see the values 3, then 7, and then ultimately 1. Once again, you will go left to right. So when you would do a level order traversal, the next values that would come would be 3, 7, and 1. Ultimately, you reach your last level and you see that you have only one value over here, 6, right? So you can simply write down 6. So you can say that given this binary tree and you have to do a level order traversal, this would be your answer. So basically, what you are doing is you are going over each level of the tree and writing down all the values from a left to right direction. But how do you make it happen? Let us find it out. A good way to solve any problem is to actually try and think what is happening over here. So when we are doing a level order traversal, notice that the elements that we encounter first are processed first, right? For example, when you are going to level number 2, what is the first element that you see? You see element 8, right? And then you see element 4. So this is the order of processing, right? And when you are at level number 3, once again, 3 is the first element you process, then 7, and then 1, right? So this should give you some idea that you need a structure where you are getting an element and then processing it in the same order as you get it. This means that if you get 8, then you are processing 8 first. If you get 4, then you are processing 4 after 8. So in a way, it should maintain some ordering. And whenever you see some ordering, the first data structure that should come to your mind is a queue data structure. That is because a queue follows the first in first out policy, right? So let us say I have a queue in front of me. What is going to happen is all the elements will go inside from over here and they will come out over here, right? So if I add the elements in order 10, 9 and 1, then they are processed in the same order, right? 10 will be processed first, then 9 and then 1, correct? So we are going to take advantage of this fact. For any tree, the root is the entry point, right? In this tree, 2 is your root. So this looks like a good starting point, right? So what I would do is, I would take this 2 and I will add it in my queue over here. So my queue becomes like this. I have the element 2 in here. Now, what you need to do is, you need to start processing this queue. Take out elements one by one. Okay, so what I do is, I take out the first element, that is 2. As soon as I take out this element, I get it on the screen, right? Now, if you remember, in the level order traversal, we were going left to right, correct? That means I need to first process the left child, then process the right child. So what I'm going to simply do is, I will add the element 8 and then 4 in my queue. Next, what we're going to do is, we will process our queue again. That means we will pop one element. As soon as I pop this element 8, I remove it and I will write it down in my output. So I got the element 8. But as soon as I pop any element, look at the left and right child of the node. When you look at the left and right child, you see the values 3 and 7, right? So since we are processing node number 8, what we can do is, we can write down its children in my queue because we know that we have to process them first. So I will write down 3 and then ultimately 7. Now move one step ahead. We will again pop another element from our queue. This time I pop out 4. As soon as I pop out my element, I will write it down in my output. And now, once again, look at the children of 4 because now you have to process it, correct? If you look at the children of 4, you don't have a left child, so do nothing, but you have a right child, correct? And that is 1. So what I will simply do is, I will add this 1 to my queue. Now keep processing your queue. You see the next element 3, so you pop it out. As soon as you pop it out, just write it down in your output. Now look at the children of 3. You don't have any children over here, right? So you don't need to add any values in your queue. Once again, what you can do is, you can keep on processing your queue. You have the value 7, so you pop it out and you will write it down in your output. You see, do they have any children? 7 does not have any children, so no elements get added in the queue once again, correct? Keep processing your queue further. The next element in the queue is 1. So I will pop out this value and as soon as I pop out, I will write down 1 on my output, correct? Now look at the children of 1. You have 6 as a child, right? So what will happen? This 6 will get in the queue. As soon as I write down 6 in the queue, I have more elements to process. Once again, I will process my queue. I see 6, I pop out this element and I will write it down in my output. And now you will see, does 6 have any children? No. So you don't add any more values in this queue. Now you try to process your queue and you see, wow, this queue is empty. That means we have processed all the elements, right? And you can see that we have successfully done a level order traversal of this binary tree. So basically, the idea over here is that for every node, put it into your queue, right? And process all its children and add it to your queue again. Keep popping elements one by one and see if they have any child. If they have any children, just add it again to the queue. Start processing them again until and unless your queue is completely empty. Now, let us try to do a dry run of the code and see how all of this is actually working. On the left side of your screen, you have the actual code to implement level order traversal. And on the right, we have the same sample tree and we will try to perform level order traversal on this. So first of all, we will pass in this root as a parameter to this function, right? Because that is the starting point. Next, we create a queue and this queue will be used to process all the elements. So So when I create this queue, it will be something like, right? So going forward, what I do is I start with the first node or the root node, and I add this root node to my queue. Once I add this node, what will happen is 2 will get in the queue, right? Now observe carefully. What do we do? We run a while loop until this queue is not empty. So this entire loop will keep on running until I have any element in the queue, right? What do I do next? I look into my queue and poll for the first element, or I pop a element. As soon as I pop a element, this tree node will get the value 2, right? So what I do over here is I will print out this value, right? As soon as I print out this value, I get 2 on my screen, and 2 is popped from that queue, correct? Now, what did you have to do next? You were looking at the left and right childs, right? So in my next step, what I do is I will add the left child of this node number 2 to my queue. So that will add node number 8 to my queue over here, correct? When this happens, node number 8 gets added to the queue. And next, I will add the right child of node 2 to my queue again. So this will add 4 to the queue over here, correct? This while loop will run again. And once again, what I do is I do a poll. So I will pop an element. This time, this tree node will get the value 8. As soon as I get the value 8, what I do is I print out this value. When I print it out, I will get 8 on my screen, and this node is popped out. In our next steps again, what I do is I add the left of this node to my queue. So this will add 3 to the queue. And then I will add the right of this node to my queue again. So this will add 7 to the queue. Now you get the idea, right? This while loop will run again. And once again, we will poll a value from this queue. As soon as I poll a value, this tree node will get the value 4, right? We print out this value 4. Once you pop out the element, you will try to add the left child to the queue. This time the left is null, right? So nothing gets added over here. And going forward, you will try to add the right child to the queue. The right child is 1, correct? So this 1 will get added to your queue over here. This loop will run again, and once again it will poll for the latest value. As soon as it polls, I will get the value 3 in my tree node, right? And once again, we will try to add all the children of 3. Ultimately, this loop will go on and you will get your output 3, 7, 1, and 6. And this is how you define a level order traversal. The time complexity of this solution is order of n. That is because you are going through each of the node. And the space complexity is also order of n. That is because you are maintaining a queue data structure that will store every element of the tree at least once. I hope I was able to simplify how you can perform a level order traversal of a binary tree. As per my final thoughts, take a moment to think and realize what could be the benefit of this traversal. Just think like this. When you were doing an in-order traversal, the first node that you wrote in your output was the leftmost node, right? When you were doing a post-order traversal, the first node that came out was the rightmost node, right? And when you did a pre-order traversal, the root was the first node that you encountered, correct? So think about some use cases when you have to find the distance between two nodes, or you need to determine, okay, what is the depth between two nodes? These are the cases when a level order traversal comes in really, really handy. Did you find some use cases where you think a level order traversal would have been helpful? Tell me everything in the comment section below. I would love to discuss all of them with you. You would be also glad to know that a text-based explanation to this content is available on the website studyalgorithms.com. You can check the link in the description below in case you want to check it out. As a reminder, if you found this video helpful, please do consider subscribing to my channel and share this video with your friends. This motivates me to make more and more such videos where I can simplify programming for you. We have a lot more videos on trees coming up, so stay tuned.